Can a landlord enter your house without you being there? Welcome back. My name is Mike Slane. Today I'm going to be talking about whether or not a landlord can enter a house without you being there. So basically, I'm talking to tenants here. My name is Mike Slane, the discount property investor. I'm a landlord. Purchased over 150 units using something called the BRRRR method, where we buy them and use little to none of our own cash. If you're interested in learning more about that, check out the freelandlordcourse.com. Again, that's freelandlordcourse.com. So getting back to the question though, is whether or not a landlord can enter a property without you being there. The answer is yes, they absolutely can. More often than not, it's in your lease agreement. And landlords, you should know this because you're the ones most likely either writing or providing the lease agreement to your tenants. So you want to clearly state when you're allowed to enter a property in the lease agreement. And tenants, it is probably in there. If it is not, you have to kind of default to what the state's local laws and ordinances are on this and on prior tenant-landlord cases. So in most places, landlords are allowed to enter without the tenant being there. They're also allowed to enter when they give you, or most of them are required rather, to give you 24 hours notice. So if a landlord is saying, hey, I want to do a routine annual or biannual inspection, we're going to do it on this date, can you be there? And you say no. More often than not, the landlord should be flexible. I mean, as a landlord, I don't want my property manager entering, or myself for that matter, entering a unit that is occupied or is rented out, but then there's no one home. That is just an invitation for trouble. Shouldn't do it. To me, it's a big red flag. I just don't think it's right. But can they legally? Yes, yes, they can. So that's really the nuts and bolts of it, guys. If you're very uncomfortable with that, you definitely need to talk to your landlord about it. Check the lease prior to signing and just state that you don't want that. We also were very pro tenants being happy in our homes, and we're very pro pet. So again, a lot of our tenants have pets, and we really don't want to enter a property if they're going to have a dog that's going to come nipping at us. Or whatever it is, you know, whatever pet they have, we're not trying to enter into that situation without them being home. So again, why do I not like this idea of entering a property without a tenant being there? Oh, it just gets you into a whole world of trouble. One, let's say that you misplaced something as a tenant and the landlord comes in, you knew they were coming in that day, then you could accuse them of stealing from you. The landlord might have actually stolen from you. Again, it's just a whole invitation to create these issues that just don't need to come about. So again, try to accommodate your landlord. More likely than not, they're just doing a routine inspection. And again, many good property managers and many good owners do this from time to time to make sure that your property is up to, you know, decent living standards. This is even required by the Section 8 housing thing. So again, if you are on the government assisted housing program, commonly referred to as Section 8, they actually require annual inspections, and they're gonna go through and make a landlord fix or repair anything that they deem to be not right. So again, that's the answer, guys. Yes, a landlord can. Should they? I don't think so. Is it a little creepy? Yes. But that is the answer there. Again, thank you so much for watching. My name is Mike Slane, the discount property investor.